So today we're going to look at the 2016 reading paper. We're going to have a look at the kind of things that you might write, how long it should take you to answer questions, and the kind of answers that you would expect to find in a mark scheme. We're just going to look for this video at the very, very first text and the first set of answers. Okay, so thinking a bit about the paper, you have to look at your standardised score. In order to get a standardised score of 100, you're looking to get roughly 21, 22 marks. Anything sort of around 34 and above is a standardised score of 110, which is kind of what you'd think of as greater depth. So the first text, which will appear on your screen now, is The Lost Queen. So take a few seconds to have a read of it, pause the screen, and then when you're happy, press play and we'll continue. Okay, so now you've taken some time to read the text, before we even go into answering any questions, we're going to go through some of the vocabulary in there that you might have found a little bit tricky. So having a look through it, the first thing that I picked out, shallows. So that idea of being in a shallow, a small lake beyond the garden. So something is shallow, not particularly very deep. So a bit like going to the beach when you dip your feet in the water, that bit is considered to be the shallows. The next bit, glancing nervously. Nervously, you might be fine with. The word glancing might be something that you struggle with. Okay, so glancing means to look around, but to do so nervously. Okay, the next one we picked out was monument. So a monument is a synonym for a big statue or something that can be used to represent a person or a place. So for example, down here, we have a picture of a monument. And finally, the last one, oars. So two things that are used to help you row through water in a boat. Okay, so now having a look at some of the questions. The first question, look at the paragraph beginning glancing nervously. Find and copy one word meaning relatives from long ago. It's a nice question because it tells you exactly where in the text you need to look. You need to find the paragraph that begins glancing nervously. Find and copy one word which means relatives from long ago. So for this question, you should dive straight back into your text, find that part and read around it. You're looking for a synonym for that meaning there. Okay, so the second question. The struggle had been between two rival families. Which word most closely matches the meaning of the word rival? So you're looking for words that are similar in meanings. The hardest thing you're going to find there is if you're not sure what the word rival means. So for that, you would go back into the text, find the word, read the sentence and see if you can understand the meaning of the word rival from the sentence that it's in. You're then ticking one word that means the same thing. Okay, and question number three. Look at page four. How can you tell that Maria was very keen to get to the island? Again, a really nice question because it tells you exactly where in the text you need to be looking. Looking at page four, and you're looking for anything that tells you that she was keen to get there. Now for this question, it is only still one mark, so I would be tempted to go back in and literally take from the text the answer. Okay, so let's look at the first question then. So it was to find and copy one word, meaning relatives from long ago. So your relatives from long ago would be your ancestors. They are relatives that were a long time ago. The next question then, so rival. Which one of these words is the closest meaning to the word rival? So if you are rivaling against somebody, you are competing. Okay, and then the last question was, how can you tell that Maria was keen to get to the island? So the key word there is keen. So words that show that she is keen would be that she behaves impatiently. Now, if you are impatient, you are keen to do something. And that's the recognition that she's rushing Oliver. So if you're rushing someone, you're telling them to hurry up. Another meaning for impatient or being keen. Okay, so looking at the next set of questions then. Number four, look at the paragraph beginning Oliver Road. Find and copy one word that suggests that the summer afternoon was quiet. Now the biggest thing that my year sixes will fall into the trap of is copying more than one word. You only literally need to go into the text to find the one word and place it into your answer. Number five, they crossed the glassy surface of the lake. Give two impressions that it gives you of the water. Now we've been working a lot on that word impressions. Impressions is just another word for feelings about that thing. What does it make you think of? So you are looking for two things, and literally again, back into the text, find the words, pop them straight into your answer. Don't go writing your own. Number six, look at the paragraph beginning, the tiny island, to the paragraph ending, were cut into. What impressions of the island do you get from these two paragraphs? So again, that word impressions, what feelings do you get? What does it make you think about the island? And finally, number seven, our first 3-mark answer of the whole test paper. Write down 3 things that you are told about the oak tree on the island. This is a nice friendly 3-mark answer. Again, all you have to do is go back into the text, find 3 different things. Be very, very careful that you are writing 3 completely different points and you're not just repeating the same thing twice. Okay then, so let's go through the answers for question number 4. Find and copy one word that suggests that the summer afternoon was quiet. So if you're quiet, you are hush, okay? Because sometimes you will say to somebody, hush. Number 5 then, they cross the glassy surface of the lake. Give 2 impressions this gives you of the water. So what do they feel in the text that the water looks like? So you could say that it was reflective, shiny or mirror-like, that it was clear, stroke transparent, still calm or undisturbed, flat and smooth. So again, if you were to choose the 2 impressions of clear and transparent, you wouldn't get that because they are the same meaning, okay? If it's clear, it is transparent. You would have to choose the different words. Number 6 then, so look at the paragraph beginning the tiny island. What impressions of the island do you get from these 2 paragraphs? So you are just taking these words directly from the text. You don't need to make these up, or what I would say to my year 6s, do not pluck them from the air. So, for example, abandoned, again, if we look at 6 here, there's 3 different meanings, unsettling, creepy, mysterious, they all mean the same. Please do not choose the 3 of those together because you would not get the 2 marks for that. You would have to choose the different ones. And then for question 7, write down 3 things. So like question 5 and question 6, you need to think of 3 different things. So if you were choosing 2 words that mean the same, you would not get the mark for that. So it is in the middle, it is very old. Again, if we're looking here, its branches are twisted, stroke bent. Well, if they are twisted, they are bent. Okay, so question number 8. Which of these drawings best represent the monument? Now, unfortunately, you're not going to get a picture of the monument in your text. What it's asking you to do is to go back into the text and read the description of when she first sees the monument. There'll be lots of description within it, and you have to pull those bits out from the text in order to find the one that closely matches the description. Question number 9, look at the paragraph beginning, Maria led Oliver. It's a 2-part question. Why did Oliver find it difficult to read the inscription on the monument? And what did he have to do in order to read the inscription? Now, the reason they've used the word inscription twice there is because it's quite a difficult word. Don't be thrown off if you don't know what the meaning of that word is. All it's asking you to find out is why it was difficult for him to read it. But you need to make sure that you don't write the same answer twice. Okay, it's why could he not read it? And then what did he do to help him read it? 2 different answers. Okay, the answers to question 8 then. Going back into your test paper to have a look at which words and phrases best describe the monument. And it is the 3rd one. Look at the paragraph beginning, Maria led Oliver. Why did Oliver find it difficult? Okay, so he found it difficult because it was mossy or dirty, it is covered, it is weathered. So how did he find it difficult? He would find it difficult to read if it was covered up. He would find it difficult to read if it was mossy or dirty and if it was weathered. What did he have to do in order to read the inscription? So how could he resolve the issue of not being able to read it? And that would be by scraping out the stuff in the letters and using his thumbnail to scratch the letters out. Okay, so on to the last 2 questions then. Number 10, what was revealed at the end of the story? Now that's quite a nice question again, because it gives you a bit of a hint about where in the text you need to go. So you need to go to the end of the story to find out what happened. Basically, you're looking for one sentence which summarises the events that happened at the very, very end. Number 11, using information from the text, tick one box in each row to show whether each statement is true or false. Be careful when you are doing this question because, as our year sixes have found, if you go back into the text, sometimes they might make a statement that appears true or false but has had a couple of words tweaked. So make sure that you go back into the text to find each individual statement to double check whether it's true or false, because we know that they like to try and catch you out. Okay then, question 10. So a technique that I've told my children to use when looking at the questions where they've got important information in is to circle what is really relevant and important in that question. So for example, in this question, what was revealed at the end of the story? End. So a lot of those statements that are on there might be true. However, they are not at the end of the story. So the one that is at the end of the story is Maria's family did not win the throne. So again, these might be true within the text, but they are not found right at the very end of the story. And the last one then, the true or false questions. So using the information from the text, I tick one box in each row to show whether each statement is true or false. So again, this is quite an easy question, a true or false, it is just ticking, but make sure that when you've read the text, you understand what has happened throughout the text. So, two families fought for the throne. Maria's family symbol was the lion. The monument was for a prince. It was hot on the island. And you need to make sure that you just ticked one box in each row, not the true and the false. And there we go. The two first ones are true and the bottom two are false.